This report is about the scientific foundations that can inform the more effective education of children from birth to age 21 in the United States whose first language is not English. This is an important study because approximately 4 to 5 million or 4.25 million children all over the United States grow up in families where their first language is not English. And many of them encounter English when they enter kindergarten or maybe for some of them early education programs. They are then presented with the challenge of both learning English as a second language and also keeping up with the academic content and subject matter that is required at their grade level. So as you can imagine, this is something that would be a very huge task for most people, but it also is a very hard task for children who are very young. I think one of the key messages of the report is that bilingualism and multilingualism is a universal human capacity. All children have the capacity from birth on to learn two languages at the same time. We also know that bilingualism is an asset. In the scientific literature, it is related to cognitive, social, and emotional development. It is related to executive functioning, which is very important in terms of cognitive flexibility, selective attention, and also in controlling one's own emotions. And finally, we are beginning to learn that bilingualism can be an asset in preventing the onset of various kinds of dementia. The final thing I would say is that the United States is one of the few countries in the world in which monolingualism is a prevalent attitude, despite the fact that if you go to many of our cities, you hear all kinds of languages. So, in what I would say, the bottom line of our report hopes to communicate is that bi and multilingualism is an asset both for individuals and for the society itself in terms of economic, social, and cultural development.